Welcome back. In this video, we are going to simulate a batch reactor in S1+. In this reactor, the acetic acid and ethanol will react to form ethyl acetate and water. So start the blank simulation and add the following components. The property package is NRTL, estimate using UNIFAC, and run this property analysis. We don't have any warning or error here, so we can go to simulation. So before configuring the reactor, batch reactor, we are going to add the reactions. We have two reactions over here and type in general. First is forward reaction, in which acetic acid and ethanol will convert into ethyl acetate and water. While in the second reaction, which is the reverse reaction, ethyl acetate and water will convert into acetic acid and ethanol. So in the kinetics, these two reactions are constant rate. The first reaction, which is forward one, has the rate of 8e⁻⁶ and activation energy is 0. And exponent is 1 for both reactants. Similarly, for the second reaction, the rate is constant with the exponent at 1. Now we will install a reactor. We have a 1 feed and 1 product stream. Feed stream has a temperature of 100 degrees C, pressure of 1 bar, and mass flow rate is 1045. The mole fraction of the feed is 0.13, 0.35, and 0.52. First of all, in the reactor section, you need to specify the operating condition, and I am going to define constant temperature. You can use either of these options. The operating temperature is 100 degrees C in my case. In the kinetics, attach the reaction set. Now, batch reactor work for the specific time span, although you can stop the reactor based on some criteria. I'm going to define one criteria over here. The location of the criteria is reactor, and in the variable type, I'm going to select the conversion. Value is 0.3 and component is acetic acid. What is going to do this? So the process will stop once the acetic acid value will reach to 0.3, when the operating time is less than the specified time. And approach from the below, it means the it will start from the 0, then 0.1, 0.2, and finally 0.3. In the operating times, I'm going to use 6 hours. So if before 6 hours this criteria will meet, the reactor will stop. If criteria is not met till 6 hours, the reactor will stop again. So our input has been completed. We can run our simulation. Results are available without any warning error. So in the results section, you can see the operating time is less than 6 hours. That means the conversion has been achieved. You can verify your conversion over here. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe channel for more updates.